Welcome to the Priory Church of St. Bartholomew the Great and to this ceremony of carols. This is one of our special carol services of the year. And normally, we'd be delighted to welcome hundreds of people, quite often as many as 600, into our ancient church, the oldest church in the City of London. But this year we can't. This year, because of COVID-19, we aren't holding it in person at all. What we are able to do is offer it up to you, wherever you are in the world, this special carol service, where all the music has been written by one man, Benjamin Britten, locked away in a cabin on a boat back to wartime Britain in 1942. It got a special, particularly special resonance this year. For the same reason that we can't hold a carol service, our musicians have found themselves almost completely out of work. And I don't just mean our wonderful musicians here in this church, and I hope you've been enjoying their offerings in some of our other carol services as well, but also all the musicians here in the UK and around the world. Which is why we've teamed up with Help Musicians, the charity which is trying to support the musicians who have found this year so very difficult. And we're contributing 25% of whatever it is that you offer up over the course of this and all our other carol services to this charity. And that's also why we're delighted to welcome some of the most eminent musicians of our age who have agreed to do the readings that intersperse this service. Not just the scripture readings, but also readings from George Herbert, which helped to give a wonderful frame to the wonderful music. And now, I know that you don't want to hear anything more from me. I'm delighted to hand over this service to those who make it and all of our services, and really all of our Christmases, so worthwhile, the musicians.
Thank you. the Annunciation to the Blessed Virgin. And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail, thou that art highly favoured, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favour with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb and bring forth a son, and shalt call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David, and he shall reign over the house of Jacob for ever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end. Then said Mary unto the angel, How shall this be, seeing I know not a man? And the angel answered and said unto her, The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. And behold, thy cousin Elizabeth, she hath also conceived a son in her old age, and this is the sixth month with her who was called barren. For with God nothing is impossible. And Mary said, Behold the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to thy word. And the angel departed from her. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. the birth of Jesus Christ. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child.
Christmas by George Herbert. After all pleasures, as I rid one day, my horse and I, both tired, body and mind, with full cry of affections quite astray, I took up the next inn I could find. There, when I came, whom found I but my dear, my dearest lord, expecting till the grief of pleasures brought me to him, ready there to be all passengers' most sweet relief. O thou, whose glorious yet contracted light
wrapped in night's mantle, stole into a manger. Since my dark soul and brutish is thy right, to man of all beasts, be not thou a stranger. Furnish and deck my soul, that thou mayest have a better lodging than a rack or grave.
The same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Saviour, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them unto heaven, the shepherds said one to another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem, and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste, and found Mary, and Joseph, and the babe lying in a manger. Thanks be to God.
Magi go to the stable. Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, Where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and are come to worship him. When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, And thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, art not the least among the princes of Judah, for out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people Israel. Then Herod, when he had privily called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, Go and search diligently for the young child, and when ye have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also. When they had heard the king, they departed. And lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh. And being warned of God in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country another way. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Nativity by George Herbert. The shepherds sing, and shall I silent be? My God, know him for thee. My soul's a shepherd too, a flock it feeds off thoughts and words and deeds. The pasture is thy word, the streams thy grace enriching all the place. Shepherd and flock shall sing, and all my powers outsing the daylight hours. Then we will chide the sun for letting night take up his place and write. We sing one common Lord, wherefore he should himself the candle hold. I will go searching till I find a sun shall stay, till we have done. A willing shiner that shall shine as gladly as frost-nipped suns look sadly. Then will we sing and shine all our own day and one another pay. His beams shall cheer my breast and both so twine, till even his beams sing and my music shine.
Thank you. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them, and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. And he that sat upon the throne said, Behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, Write, for these words are true and faithful. And he said unto me, It is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. He that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. Thanks be to God.
God sent his only Son into the world. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God, and everyone that loveth is born of God and knoweth God. He that loveth not knoweth not God, for God is love. In this was manifested the love of God toward us, because that God sent his only beloved Son into the world, that we might live through him. Herein is love. Not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the propitiation for our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we ought also to love one another. No man hath seen God at any time. If we love one another, God dwelleth in us, and his love is perfected in us. Hereby know we that we dwell in him and he in us, because he hath given us of his Spirit. And we have seen and do testify that the Father sent the Son to be the Saviour of the world. Whoever shall confess that Jesus is the Son of God, God dwelleth in him, and he in God. And we have known and believed the love that God hath to us. God is love, and he that dwelleth in love dwelleth in God, and God in him. Herein is our love made perfect, that we may have boldness in the day of judgment, because as he is, so are we in this world. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
I'm really thrilled that the rector has agreed that 25% of the net proceeds of this online carol service should go to a charity called Help Musicians. As you probably know, freelance musicians have rather fallen through the net of government support, and their plight in many cases is really rather terrible. So many thanks to you for anything you can give, knowing that 25% will go to Help Musicians. Thank you.